And welcome back, everybody, to Sports Weekly on IEMG. Let's talk a little high school baseball in this segment. Now, if you remember this from this past season, we had a couple teams go to a CIF Southern Section Championship game. We had Cajon versus Citrus Valley, an all-local final in Division 5. And then in Division 7, we had the Arroyo Valley Hawks. The Hawks going all the way to the finals. They played Lancaster for the D7 Championship at Long Beach State University. And the Hawks coming so close, falling the Lancaster final score 3-2 in that championship game. Jake Niesel was the head coach. Denis Dufour was an assistant on his staff. And now Dufour steps in as the head coach of the Hawks this season. And he says there's not a lot of guys coming back from that team that went all the way to the championship game. There's a couple of them, but they've got some good young players. If they can start scoring some runs and put some things together here, he says this Arroyo Valley team could be pretty good again this season. He's excited about this opportunity and the challenge of having another successful year with the Hawks. Here is head coach Denis Dufour on Sports Weekly. We are out here at Arroyo Valley High School. Baseball practice going on behind us. We're joined by Denis Dufour, the head coach of the Hawks. And coach, before we get to your team and, you know, the season, which has already started for you guys, I love the shirt. It says, get 1% better every day. So what does that mean to this team this season?
You know, it was kind of like a motto I adopted last year as an assistant working under Coach Niesel, and the kids thought it was hilarious. They were like, they bought into it 100%, and it was like, you know, it's about a foundation building. You got to get 1% better. We're not asking you to get 100% better every day. I want you to get 1% better. And what that means to us and our program over here is, hey, if you strike out four times and you only strike out three the next time, you got better. You got 1% better. So that's the kind of foundation. If you make an error, next game you don't make an error. That's what we're talking about, doing this 1% better thing. So that was kind of a slogan that we adopted last year, and I thought I would bring it as the head coach this year. It's kind of like our mantra a little bit.
Well, if you adopted it last year, it must have worked. You guys went to a CIF Southern Section Championship game in Division 7. You know, I'm looking at the squad this year. It's a lot of new faces, not a lot of new guys, but I feel like maybe having gone to a championship game, that standard, that expectation might feel different this year, right? I mean, even with new guys, do you feel like, hey, this is, we're expected to win now?
Yeah, I definitely like the having the expectations. You know, for a long time, Arroyo Valley was an afterthought to most people out here for baseball. And, you know, you had one good year, and now people know who we are.
Yeah.
And I want to continue that excellence that was set by the previous coaching staff, Coach Niesel, Coach Clokey last year. I want to continue that. I want to build upon that. That's where that 1% better comes from. You know, we have a foundation. We had our first ever alumni game at the beginning of the season, and we had 13, 14 guys. We had guys from the last couple years, and we actually had guys from 2016 come out. So people are buying in. People know now. So this is about building something, and we're just going to build it brick by brick every day. Come out here, grind. We got grinders out here every day. Can't ask for a better group of kids.
All right, Coach, we're already a couple games into this season. Just looking at the scores, maybe it looks like the pitching and defense is there, but the hitting is still coming around. But I think for a lot of teams, hitting always has to catch up to the pitching anyways, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, we struggled with the bats for quite a while, the first maybe four games. Thank God yesterday we were able to come away with a victory, put some runs on the board. But, you know, our pitching has kept us into so many games. I've got so many good pitchers. Diego Marquez is a junior, and he's been lights out. We have Memo Carrasco, who pitched a complete game. We lost 1-0 to Miller. We had a senior yesterday, Julio Arceo, who threw yesterday, did a great job, only giving up one unearned run. So we definitely have some good pitching, make some a little better defense, and we're definitely in game. So if our bats can come around, we have a chance to do some good things.
So I know it's early, and looking at the win-loss record, it might not be the best, but it's still, you're optimistic because you have been in all of these games thanks to some great pitching.
Yeah, you know, we try to say, let's get better, that 1%, you know, and we're gonna make mistakes. I'm okay with that. We're relatively young. Yesterday, we started two freshmen. Chances are, at tomorrow's game, we're gonna start three freshmen. So we're young, and it's okay to make mistakes, but you gotta have the belief that we're going to get that 1% better. And, you know, every day, we just keep building and building and building. And I've got, like I said, I've got a great group of kids who are a pleasure to work with. I've got a great coaching staff that I was able to put together, and I couldn't be happier being here at Arroyo Valley and building hopefully a championship contender for the next three or four years.
Years to come, right?
Exactly.
All right, speaking of this year's group, this year's team, we mentioned off the top there's not a lot of familiar faces. Mm-hmm. So of that team that went to the championship game last year, how many guys are back and how many young guys do you have coming up? Because it sounds like there is a lot of young guys.
You know, I got probably about three or four that were that contributed a lot to last year's team. We'll start off with our pitcher, Diego Marquez. He was our opening day guy. Awesome. He's a great junior. He really peaked at the end of the year. He had our game-winning hit against Rim to help clinch the league title last year as a sophomore. But on the mound, he has just grown. His velocity has increased. He's got good movement on some pitches, and he's battle-tested. And then we got a couple of good senior arms that are through for us. Memo Carrasco, like I said, threw a complete game, and I felt bad for him. He did an excellent job when we were at Miller. We just couldn't swing the bats, lost 1-0. And then we still have another senior, Julio Arceo, who pitched yesterday against Indian Springs, did a great job for us. Good command, good velocity, and when he's not pitching, he plays an excellent center field for us. So probably our best overall hitter as well. So really looking forward to see how he can develop from now until the end of the year.
All right, Coach, let's wrap it up like this. Obviously, going through last season and making it to that championship game, obviously you have to score runs, you got to have pitching, you got to play defense, but was there something intangible, was there something just special about last year's team that you're hoping to maybe you could, you know, stuff it into a bottle and, you know, use it for this year's squad as well? Because sometimes there's always that it factor that a championship team has. Do you feel like you could maybe put your, you know, pinpoint what that might be?
You know, what last year team, they had a lot of competitive grit. Mm-hmm. And we want to have that competitive grip. Like I said, it doesn't matter who we play. I want us to go out there and compete every pitch, every at bat, every out, every hit. I want us to compete. And so if I could take that competitive grit from our team last year, I think we could be really, really good and build on that for years to come.
So far, does it look like it?
You know what? There are times when I think we have it, and other times I think we don't. But like I said, the young guys, especially, you know, I've got a young second baseman, George Reyes, who played last three games for us, and he's probably swung the bat the best out of anybody as a freshman, and he's probably no bigger than 5 foot. So that kid is a grinder, and he's the type of kid that we have here. These guys who want to play baseball, and I love these group of guys. This is my first group of guys being a head coach, so it's always going to be special to me. So we're going to keep that momentum going, and hopefully, you know, when league play comes in a couple of weeks, we're ready to go.
Well, Coach, we appreciate the time. Best of luck the rest of the way, and we'll have to pop into some of your games, get some highlights this season.
Appreciate it. Thank you for coming out.
Yes, sir.
With us today.
You got it. It's Denis Dufour, head coach of your Arroyo Valley Hawks.
And best of luck to Coach Dufour and the Hawks this season. Make sure you subscribe to the IE Media Group YouTube channel so you can stay up to date with all the segments here on Sports Weekly. Plus, we've got some live baseball scheduled in the next couple of weeks as the County Clash returns to San Manuel Stadium. So we'll have some high school games live. So make sure you subscribe as well to the IE Media Group YouTube channel so that way you'll get quick alerts when we go live on the channel. My name is Pep Fernandez. We always appreciate you tuning in. We'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.